As you can see, folks, right behind me here is the Linsky GR250, and this is actually a bike I reviewed long term with Linsky. You're better off just checking out the review I posted recently. That explains my thoughts on the bike and how much I like it. But so, Mark, tell me what was your thought, I guess, about designing such a bike for this type of riding? I mean, a lot of people, I emphasize this in my video, don't really factor in big tire clearance, and you've actually done that with this bike. Mm-hmm. So what was some of the thought process that went into the design of the GR250 frame set?
Well, you know, as that segment came alive and matured, and it's been a really interesting evolution to watch.
Sure.
As to why is gravel riding becoming as popular as it's becoming, and as any of us that have ever ridden a road bike know, no matter what clubs or you're trying to do to improve the quality of road riding, it's tough to get out there and find a stretch of road where you can relax, not worry about getting run over. So obviously, but yet I don't want to go mountain biking.
Right.
And so it kind of becomes a combining of the two.
A marriage of the two, yeah.
Yeah. And so it's real, you know, from an engineering perspective, it's okay, let's take a cyclocross bike, let's take a mountain bike, and let's take a road bike, and let's put them in a blender.
That's a good analogy.
That's just kind of what you did.
Yeah.
And so obviously comfort comes into play.
Yeah, that's,
right out of the gate.
That's huge.
Comfort.
Yeah, that's huge.
Which leads into everything. And so for us, doing all the different types of things we've done in bikes and understanding how to manipulate a tube to achieve different types of comfort, the frame design was pretty quick and easy.
Mm-hmm.
But now going back to comfort, well, what's okay? Comfort in the frame is one thing, but obviously in today's world and trends, bigger tires.
Mm.
Across the board, people are wanting, on their road race bikes, they're wanting to run 28s and 30s, with, you know, 28 tire with 28 rim, okay.
Oh, yeah.
And it's actually a good thing.
Sure.
So tire clearance, you know, everybody wants to run bigger tires, but they still have a road bike mindset. And, okay, and if you've ever tried to truly design a rear end that performs well, short chain stays, this area down in here is tight.
Yes.
And it's one thing for you and I to go, oh, you know, we put a 45 tire in there. Do you, the complexities of making everything work and chain lines and Shimano and SRAM are wanting to make the Q factors tighter.
Mm.
And everybody wants everything tighter, but oh, by the way, can you make a bigger tire fit in with all this? And unfortunately, the frame builder is the last one on the list.
Mm.
Shimano didn't call me up and go, can you really make a frame that this fits in? They might have asked Trek. They didn't ask me. So for us boutique frame builders, it's really a challenge, especially in our world, as we've talked about time and time again, I want a performance bike.
Mm.
You know, I want something that's my world of what I define as high performance, not the norm. Yeah. Oh, if I could add, you know, put it out to a 435, 450 chainstay, no problem. You could park a bulldozer in there. But no, but then you're not going to have a performance bike. So that was a big challenge for us, and how do you do it, and how do you maintain the stiffness of the rear end using the alloys that we want to use, and the bigger the chain ring, the better, more options for the rider. And so as you can tell, that's what it took a while to figure that out and do it. But that's how we dealt with the tire clearance thing. We also, there were no forks out there. You know, we wanted the 45 tire or a minimum of the 2.1 by 27.5. And the 3T had a fork.
Oh, the Luteus 2.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Luteus,
the Luteus 2.
Luteus 2, yeah.
That did have those parameters.
Mm.
It's a great fork.
Oh, yeah.
To make a mistake, but
yeah.
Kind of pricey,
yeah,
and it also didn't have some of the performance characteristics that we were looking for relative to that balance of comfort versus
mm-hmm.
performance. And so, the next thing on the list was we need to make our own fork.
Good.
chip for this. And so, you know, that's the fork that's on here. We labeled the GR Pro. That's another think tank name. So that's how, very simply, the GR came along. And then, again, as you're getting the GR Pro, which is our 6.4 version of it, which is, it has the same geometry, same tire clearances, etc. The tube set's significantly different for that person that's going to spend 60 or 80% of their time racing instead of 10 or 20.
Gotcha.
And that's why it exists.
And if you're watching this video, folks, that's actually the bike I'm picking up later on today from Linsky to review, so keep posted on that. So I think we're going to do a factory tour pretty soon, so have a look around the operations of Linsky and see how the bike suffers tubes and how they end up into actual bicycle frames for you to purchase.